Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube class. In this video we are going to talk about the output questions with respect to the LCF ladder. In the previous video we have seen the working and the syntax of LCF ladder. We have also seen when to use the LCF ladder. Now let us try to understand the working of LCF ladder with the help of few examples. Now let's see the first example over here. Int y, the y value is initialized with 3. If the value of y is 3, then we have to execute this else if. This is the body of the next condition, and we have the else block, and this printf y, the value of y which is being printed in the printf statement, is outside the control of the else if ladder. This is the next set of statement. Now what is the else if ladder over here? This complete thing is the else if ladder. This complete thing is the else if ladder. And how does the else if ladder will work? First it will evaluate the condition 1. If the condition 1 is true, it will be evaluated and the control directly come out of the else if ladder. If the condition 1 is false, then the condition 2 will be evaluated. If it is true, then it will be evaluated and it will directly come out of the else if ladder. And if condition 2 happens to be false, then it will evaluate condition 3 if it is anything else, it will evaluate the body of else. Now let's try to understand the working of this and try to write down the output for this particular question. Now before I write the output of this question, I want everyone to pause the video over here and try to write down the output of this particular question. Okay, yeah, please do it. I hope that you should be able to do it by now. Now what we have? We have one variable y. Let the address of the variable y be say 0x1000. You can give any address of your choice. And the value of y happens to be 3. And the value of y happens to be 3. Now it will evaluate the condition 1. What is condition 1? Y equal 3. What is the value of y? 3. Is 3 equal 3? Yes, 3 is equal 3. Since the condition 1 is true, this should be evaluated. And what does it will print? It will print 1 on the output screen. And it will say the value of y happens to be 5. That means this 3 is overwritten with 5. Right. Now, after you execute the body of if, it should directly come out of the else if ladder and it should print the value of y. And what is the value of y? The value of y happens to be 5 over here. Notice one thing, even though the second condition is true, because the value of y is 5, it won't evaluate the second condition. This is how the else if ladder will work. That means as soon as the condition 1 is evaluated, no other conditions will be checked and it directly comes out of the else if ladder. Therefore, the output for this question is 1 is printed and the recent value of y happens to be 5. Okay. Now, similarly, again, I want you to pause the video over here and I want you to try question number B and try to write down the output. Yeah, please do it. Okay. I hope you have been done. Now, again, we have one variable over here. What is the variable y? The value of y is 3 and you can assume any address of your choice. Okay. Now notice one thing over here. There is no word called as else over here. That means this is not a else if ladder. Now this is if else. Else is always associated to previous if. Now that means this else is associated to this if, not this else is not associated to this if. That means this particular thing happens to be an if else and this is a separate independent if. This is a separate independent if. Now what is the value of y? 3. This is from where we start. 3 equal 3. Yes, 3 is equal to 3. Therefore, what will happen? It will print to 1 and the value of y from 3 is overwritten to 5. Fair enough. Now this if is done. Now this is a separate if else. But in this case, we have written else if over here. Therefore, this complete thing has become else if ladder. And this complete thing has not become else if ladder since we have not written else over here. Now, what is the value of y? 5. 5 equal 5? Yes, 5 is equal to 5. Therefore, it will print 2 as well. And the value of y from 5 will change to 7. Now, the recent value of Y7. Now notice one thing, since this if has executed, else block should not be executing it, and it prints the value of Y. And what is the recent value of Y? The recent value of Y is 7. I hope you have understood the difference between the else if ladder and what if we only write if and if else. Now the question comes one thing, sir, why it is called as ladder? Because first you check the condition one. Now it is as good as a ladder and you want to reach the top, right? Now what you do, you keep the ladder, you take the first step of the ladder and you see that have you been able to reach the top. If yes, you won't take this second step, and if you are unable to reach the top, then you will take the second step, and so on. Similarly over here, first you check the condition one. If you are able to satisfy the condition, you stop the else if ladder because you are being able to reach the top. Now if you are unable to reach the top of the roof, wherever you want to go, then you will check the second condition, right? Then you will take the second step of the ladder. Therefore it is called as an else if ladder. Okay, now let's see some more questions on the output of the else if ladder. Let us see some of the questions on the else if ladder. Now before I solve these questions, I want you to pause the video, give a think about these questions and try to write down the output of this. Now for this, please watch my videos on the if and the if else to be able to solve better. And the description, in the description section, I will be giving the link for the if and if else. Please pause the video and try to solve it. Okay. Now the one thing which comes to our mind is, what is the body of if, or what is the body of else if or else? It is the immediate statement or the immediate block. And we know one thing, that a semicolon is called as the null statement. Now what do I mean by null statement? Null statement means do nothing. It's do nothing. Right. Now observe one thing over here, as in the previous example, this is a separate thing and this is a separate thing. Okay. I'm not calling this complete thing as a if, because we have something called as semicolon and this if is the separate thing. And what is the body of if? It is semicolon. It means what? It means if the condition is true, evaluate the semicolon, that means execute semicolon, that means do nothing. And if the condition is false, do not evaluate semicolon. Okay, and this is a separate block and this is a separate if else, and at finally we will print the value of Y. Let's try to understand how does this program works. Now this is a variable Y. The value of the variable Y is 4, and you can assume any address of your choice. Now 4 equal equal 5, the condition is false. Now since the condition is false, the body of if should not be executed. And what is the body of if, can you tell me? Yes, you are thinking right. The body of if is the semicolon, that means do nothing. Now 4 equal equal 5 is false, do not execute semicolon, that means this if is being skipped, but this is the next block that we need to execute it. This is not covering the if itself, therefore it will print 1 and the value of Y from 4 will change to 5. Now this should be evaluated. What is the recent value of Y? 5. 5 equal equal 5, yes, it will print 2 as well, and the value of Y from 5 will change to 8. That means the recent value is 8. Now since if has executed, else should not execute, and the value of Y is 8. That is the recent value of Y. Therefore the output is 1, 2 and Y equal 8. Now let's try to understand this question. Now again you see a semicolon over here. Now this is the semicolon. That means the body of this else if is the semicolon. Now remember one thing, in an else if ladder, there should not be any body or any block or any statement between two else if. Now what do I mean by this? It means between this else if and this else, this is the extra thing that we are getting. Why this is the extra thing that we are getting? Because the body of this ELSIF is semicolon. Right? Again, I am repeating, in ELSIF ladder or in a normal if else, there should not be anything, or anything in the sense, no block or no statement between ELSIF and another ELSIF, or between if and else, or between if else and, sorry, between ELSIF and else. Is that okay? Now, this is something which is in between the body of this ELSIF and this else. This is something in the body of this ELSIF and this else. This is something. And this is a syntax error. And this syntax error, we call it as else without previous if. This we call it as else without previous if. That means you have found an else, but there is no corresponding matching else if, or there is no matching if over here. Therefore, it is an error, right? But the same question, if I write it as, yeah, please observe over here. But the same question, if I add an if block over here and I say if y equal 6 and I write here printf3, else printf4, and here I print the value of y. Printf y is equal to %d/n, y. If the same position, I modify it this way. Now check over here, it will, this is the body of if, this is the body of else if. Now what did I say? That else is optional in else if ladder. There is no else, that is perfectly okay. Now this becomes the else if ladder for us. This is the else if ladder, and these are the next set of statements. Again, here we are finding an if else over here, and we want to print the value of y at the end. It means the else block is completely optional. But having you have written else if over here, this would give an error. Why? Because there should not be any block or body between one else if to another else if. But we have written only one if over here. Now let's see the output of this. What is the value of y? The value of y is 4. I just write the value of y is 4. 4 equal 5 is false. It comes out. Now, since the first condition is false, this is an else if ladder, it should evaluate the second condition. Now, what is the recent value of y? 4. 4 equal 4. Yes, it is true. Now, since it is true, it should evaluate the body of else if. And what is the body of else if? Semicolon will be executed. That means do nothing. Now, this completes the else if ladder, and it should try to execute the next set of statements from here. And that means this else if ladder effectively does nothing, because even though the condition is true, you are doing nothing over there. Okay. Now, you print the next set of statements, you print 2, and the value of y from 4 will become 2, 7. Now, again, we have an if else over here. Is 7 equal 6? The condition is false. Therefore, the body of else should get executed, and it will print 4. And at last, we will print the value of y. And what is the recent value of y? 7. Therefore, the output is 2, 4, and y equal to 7. If I modify this particular thing, and without modifying it, that was an error. And that error, we called it as else without previous if. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have enjoyed this video, please hit on the like button. Please subscribe to my channel and share this channel with your friends. Thank you, friends, for watching this.